We're going to be talking about these quantities so much, let's give them some abbreviations. Position, I'm going to abbreviate with the variable x, and velocity, I'll use the variable v. Now, we just said that measuring an object's velocity is somehow measuring how fast its position is changing. Well, we can write that with an equation. This equation says that velocity is equal to the change in x over the change in time, the change in position over change in time. This triangle here is the Greek letter delta, and it represents change. X represents position. This mathematical definition really ties in with our intuitive definition of what velocity means. Before we go any further, let's also talk about how we're going to measure these quantities. What units are we going to use? To measure position, we're going to use the unit meter, which we abbreviate m. Well, velocity is just position, which is meters, divided by some unit of time. And the unit of time we like to use is the second. So, second. Meters per second. If we were Aristotle, we would stop here, because if an object falls with constant velocity, the velocity never changes. We don't really care about anything else. Position and velocity seem to be enough to quantify motion. But we're talking about Galileo, and for him, speed is constantly changing. This concept of changing speed is so important, we give it its own word, acceleration. And we'll abbreviate that A. And acceleration is a measure of how an object's velocity changes with time, just as velocity measured an object's positional change with time. Using this idea that acceleration is change in velocity, can you complete this equation which defines acceleration?